Junkfood Taster.com's episode 3065. And this is something I think interesting. It's Chebbi filled wafers with fruit flavors. And it comes packed in this frisbee. So basically, you get a frisbee alongside your candy bag. And here's like ingredients list. It's very light. It's just 27.5 grams. And yeah, let's unwrap it. So yeah, I can't really throw the frisbee. Yeah, I could little bit here. I think it will fly very well. Anyway, so let's check out these. And they're actually four different flavors. So interesting. Strawberry, apple, lemon, and orange. It's like also nutrition facts. It's mainly sugar. Sugar and water then. Okay. Okay. The company behind all of this is Hitchler. Okay, so... And it's sorted. Okay. Anyways, here's the ingredients list. If you are interested. For instance, there's beetroot red. Very good. Let's open it. Ah, let's get a sizzle. So here we go. Equipment is here. Let's open. This wafer smells good. Reminds me on, yeah, like this wafer smell like. And there are even multicolor ones, which is quite interesting, I think. Anyway, so you know what time it is. Yep, let's do it. Let's cut one. Here we go. I always cut that. This was a funny cut, and so I sort of pushed it down, and then it sort of bent it over and exploded. Very good. Let's try the second time, whether it behaves the same the second time. I think this is now all about, yeah, it really does. I think it's all about texture here. And I hope this will be a fantastic mouth feeling. And I sort of start off with pink, I think. Let's do it. Okay. Oh, sour. So first of all, you are biting in this kind of shell or something. It feels kind of wicked to have this in your mouth. It feels a little bit like a ping pong ball or something. Then you got the Chebbi powder. Don't ask me for flavors. I think this was sour, super sour as well. But the cutting of these guys is really funny. Let's do it a third time here. Here we go. Bam. Okay, so I think now I had blue and green, so now I think yellow. Okay, this is not super sour, this is lemon. I said blue is apple. And the red should be strawberry. But I think it's just sour. Last but not least, what did I just eat here? Orange. Yeah, maybe orange. Alright. This is now a very special product. I think maybe the only product out there that is that way. Maybe we have like a wafer which has some Chebbi powder inside. Never seen something similar, actually. And it's so exotic. This product is ultimately exotic that you sort of have no other chance to rate it gourmet. I think at least if you haven't tried it out, you can't really judge. I think if you are a fan of Chebbi powder, this is probably the ultimate way to have a shabby powder snack. I'm not necessarily think whether anybody wants to snack shabby powder, but if you want to, this is like the most awesome way to do it. So this basically means gourmet, so it's super specialized product. All right, so if you have tried these, it says here Hitchler International, it has also English ingredients. I don't know, they must sell these maybe in a lot of countries, I don't know. Then let me know what you think about these. Have you tried them? Or have you tried a similar product? Let me know whether you know a similar product. This would be also interesting for me. Anyways, this was a review. What do you think about the Frisbee? Is this a good idea or not? Yeah. I think this little thing maybe also resembles Frisbee. I don't know. Let's have it again. And thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this review. And see you next episode. Okay, Hitchler, die Brauseflummis, sauer und fruchtig. Sie sind wirklich sauer, also ich muss jetzt mein Gesicht verziehen. Ah, viel Geschmacksrichtung, aber davon kriegt man nicht mit, ist eigentlich zu sauer. Gut, meistens Zucker, bisschen Wasser und ein bisschen andere Kohlenhydrate noch. Genau, hier ist die Zutatenliste, zum Beispiel ist drin das gute Indigotin 1. Okay, ja, kommt noch mit dem Frisbee, also ja, ich mache jetzt nicht extra, wo ich das zeige, wie ich den werfe. Ich denke mal, der fliegt gut. Und das ist jetzt, also sowas habe ich noch nicht gesehen, das sind solche Obladen, also basically sag ich schon. Im Wesentlichen sind das zwei Obladen, in dem halt Brausepulver drin ist. Zerplatzt lustig, wenn man es zerschneidet, guck mal. Ist auch sehr elastisch. Ich habe gesagt, es fühlt sich so ein bisschen an wie einen Tischtennisball. Als würde man Tischtennisball, wobei ich noch nie einen Tischtennisball, es ist nur so von der Assoziation her, ne? Und ja, also das ist super speziell. Ich kenne auch gar kein ähnliches Produkt wie das. Keine Ahnung. Und das ist im Prinzip, wenn man so mag, Shabby Powder, also Brausepulver zu essen und das nicht aus der Tüte essen will, sondern das so elegant snacken will, ist das perfekt. Da steckt man sich einfach diese Oblate in den Mund, zerkaut die Oblate. Und dann so läuft dann das saure Brausepulver in der Gusche. Ja. Also für alle Brausepulver-Fans ist das so optimal. Muss es ja wohl Leute geben, die auf Brausepulver stehen. Sonst gibt es ja diese Produkte nicht. Und für diese Leute ist das super, deshalb Gourmet. Jetzt so der Mainstream-Konsument wird es vielleicht nicht gerade kaufen, ich weiß es nicht. Also Brausepulver ist ja schon so ein Nischenmarkt, würde ich sagen, und von daher. Ja, genau. Gut, seid ihr Brausepulver-Fans? Kennt ihr ein anderes Produkt, was so ist? Und ja, das wäre es soweit. Danke, dass ihr euch die Folge angeschaut habt. Und bis zur nächsten Folge.